Well, good afternoon. I'm praying to God that he will keep me well. I feel okay now, but I'm praying he'll keep me well throughout the night, that I can awaken tomorrow refreshed and ready to go to church. This is Pastor Hayton in the Lord Lights Devotional, and I sure don't want to miss church tomorrow. Now, I know a lot of people don't make it a practice of being in church at every Sunday, and I'm not your judge. I'm not going to judge you by that at all. Might pray for you, but I won't judge you. I know a lot of people are kept from church by working at a job of mercy. Hospitals have to be staffed and the ill have to be taken care of. And I realize that a lot of people are going to be sick tomorrow. Seems like a lot of junk going around already this winter, and colds and flu, and I don't know what other bugs might be floating around, but some people are not going to be able to get up out of bed. And if you've got the flu, if you have a bad cold, please do stay in bed. I don't want it. Don't come and infect the rest of us. And so, you know, there's a lot of reasons people aren't going to be in church tomorrow. Working that job of mercy, being ill, maybe just kind of thinking of something they'd rather do. Something that perhaps is demanding their attention. Some people may have an ox in the ditch tomorrow. Heard the story about, you know, how Jesus said, if a man has an ox in the ditch, well, surely you'll get it out on the Sabbath, but it has to be an ox in the ditch. In other words, something that just has to be done. Heard about the preacher that told someone who was always missing church because he said he had an ox in the ditch. Preacher said, well, you'd better sell the oxen or you'd better fill up the ditch. And so if it's the ox in the ditch that is keeping you from church a lot, probably ought to fill up the ditch or sell the ox and get back to church. But like I say, I'm not going to judge anybody. I know your church attendance is between you and God. And if you think you can worship God in nature, or you can worship God at home, why, that's totally between you and God. But I don't want to miss church, what I'm trying to get at today. I'm excited about being in the house of the Lord tomorrow. I'm excited about our corporate worship. We worship God each day in many different ways, of course, but to me, there's just nothing like corporate worship where we come together, sing the good songs of the church, and pray together and open our hearts to the Word of God and enjoy the fellowship of people of like spirit and kindred faith. I just don't want to miss church tomorrow. So I'm praying God to keep me well, and praying God to keep the ox out of the ditch, and praying that, you know, I'll just be able to be here my Sunday best. I know I like to dress up for church because I believe God deserves the very best that we have in every area of our life, and we're stepping into the presence of Almighty God Himself, a majestic God that is high and lifted up, and I want to look my best. I'm going to be sure my suit is pressed and my shirt is ironed and I've got a tie that matches the suit and my shoes are shined, because I want to be at my best tomorrow and look my best when I come to worship God. So, you know, I'm excited about worship tomorrow, and I'm trusting that God will once again meet with His people. So if you're not planning on going to church, and you already know probably whether you'll be there or not, why don't you make plans to find a house of worship and enjoy all the blessings and the benefits of corporate worship with God's people on God's day. Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for the churches that dot our land. We thank Thee, Lord, for these houses of worship. Many have been erected by the sacrifice of someone, and Lord, we're enjoying the fruits of their labor today by having a place where we can come and worship You together. And Lord, put within our hearts a desire to be in the house of God. Pray, Lord, that those that don't normally go to church, would You draw them to a place of worship and let them discover the blessing and the benefit of worshiping You. So bless us throughout the evening, on down throughout our life, in Jesus' name, amen. Well, thanks for just letting me share that. And I'll see you tomorrow or Monday on Lord Lights Devotional. Hope to see a bunch of you at the Lighthouse Chapel. Goodbye now.